Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you a super quick and easy way to create a watermark that you can access at any time and customize to blend well into any of your photos or other images. Open an image that you'd like to make into a watermark. It should be black on a white background. Check its size by going to Image and Image Size. Make its width and height anywhere between 500 to 1000 pixels and its resolution 300 pixels per inch to ensure it'll be big enough to use on pretty much any image. Remember, it's always better to scale it down than to scale it up. If you'd like to add a copyright symbol next to your image, I'll show you how to do it next. However, if you don't want to add the symbol, you can jump to 2 minutes and 33 seconds in the video to bypass this section. Go to Image and Canvas Size. Change the measurement to percent and click the right middle arrow, which will add extra room on the left. Type in 130 for the width, which will give us enough room for the symbol. If the canvas extension color box isn't white, click it to open the color picker and pick white. Then click OK on both windows. Open your horizontal type tool and make sure black is your foreground color. Pick a font. Make its size at least 50 pixels so we can see the symbol when we type it. Click next to your image. If you're using Windows, press and hold the Alt key while typing 0169 on the 10-key keypad to create the copyright symbol. On Macs, press and hold the Option key while typing the letter G on your keyboard. To make the copyright symbol bigger, highlight it and drag the text icon to the right. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. Merge the two layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Go to Edit and Define Brush Preset. Name it whatever you'd like. Immediately, you'll see an outline of the actual brush. Open your brush picker. If you'd like to access your watermark quickly, move it to the top left corner of the panel. Open up an image that you'd like to add your watermark to. Make sure the opacity and flow are both 100%. To reduce its size, press the left bracket key on your keyboard, but before you do it, make sure your caps lock key is off, otherwise the size won't change. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. To pick a color for the watermark, open your eyedropper tool by pressing the letter I on your keyboard. Click a spot on your image to pick up that particular color. Press B to open back up your brush tool, go to a corner, and click once. If you want a different color, no problem. Press X to undo the last step and pick a different color with your eyedropper tool. To show your photo a little through the watermark, just reduce its opacity. You can also experiment with blend modes to create different ways the watermark will interact with the photo. First, I'll increase its opacity back to 100%. For this example, I'll click Soft Light. It's that simple. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.